today's video lecture of maths. Students, yesterday we have learned to find LCM by prime factorization method. Okay, what we had done in that, when two numbers were given and we had to find their LCM. So by prime factorization method, so we found prime factors of both the numbers. Also, we took common factors. Okay, this made box to the common factors. And you know, LCM means common factors multiplied by non-common factors. So we multiply first. We took first common factors in the form of multiplication into again multiplication multiply by other non-common remaining non-common factors, and we multiply all to find the LCM. Okay, so that was the one of the method to find LCM, least common multiple. Here today we are going to learn the another method of finding lowest common multiple, that is LCM. That the method is short division method. Now if you remember, before 3 or 4 days we have taken this method, we have learned this method to find HCF, highest common factor, right? To find HCF, or we have found HCF by short division method. Same method we are going to apply to find LCM. Just little changes there, little changes there. What is that change? Let's see here. Find LCM by short division method. And the numbers are given 10, 12, 16 and 18. We have to find the LCM. Now, once again I repeat, LCM is what? Lowest common multiple. Means such number which is in table of all these number. Such a lowest common multiple of all these number means the number which is in table of 10 as well as 12 as well as 16 as well as 18. Okay, so such lowest number we have to find. Okay, so as I told you, for short division method, what we do like this. Okay, I must write here all numbers, all given numbers. Okay, 4 numbers we have written. And you know our prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, and so on. Okay, so first what we are going to check. In LCM, in HCF, what we had done, we took common factor in all given numbers. We found common factor or common prime factor of all given numbers. In LCM, there is concession, we can say. If we are not getting common factor of all, we can find common factor of any 3 numbers or any 2 numbers also. Okay, first we will check whether is there any common prime factor of given all 4 numbers. Okay, if when we will not get common factor of all 4 numbers, we will check for 3 numbers. If you are not getting for 3, we will check for 2. Okay, so that this is the change. In HCF, what we had done, we found common factor of all given numbers. We found only the common factor of all given 4 numbers. Here this is there is a concession. If you are not getting common factor of all 4 numbers, you will find any 3 or any 2 also. Okay, so how to do that? See here. Now see 10 12 16 and 18, both our first prime number is 2, so where we will check by 2 whether all these numbers are divisible by 2. Here once again we have learned divisibility test. Those divisibility tests you have to apply here to check whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not. So last digit is 0, 2, 6 and 8. So they are divisible by 2. I am writing 2 here. Okay. Divide 10 by 2. 2 5s are 10. 2 6s are 12. 2 8s are 16. And 2 9s are 18. Now seeing this second step. The new numbers which we have obtained, they are 5, 6, 8 and 9. Now here if you will observe, all 4 numbers are they divisible by first prime number 2? Are all numbers divisible by first prime number 2? Yes, 6 and 8 are not divisible, but 5 and 9, they are not in table of 2, not divisible by 2. Okay, so what we can do here? Okay, all 4 numbers are not divisible by 2, but any 3 or any 2 are divisible. Which 2 are divisible? 6 and 8. Right? 6 and 8 are divisible by 2. So we will take 2 here. Now, phi is not divisible by 2, so phi take as it is down. Phi is not divisible by 2, so phi take as it is down. 9 is not divisible by 2, 9 take as it is down. Fine? And which numbers are divisible by 2? 6 and 8. These two numbers are divisible by 2, so we have taken 2 here. Divide 6 by 2. 2, 3 is a 6 and 2, 4 is a 8. Okay? Finish. Now see here, in this step, there is 5, 3, 4 and 9. Are there all 4 numbers divisible by any common prime factor? Prime number, no. Any 3? Are there any 3 numbers which are divisible by that, any of the prime number? 3 also no. Any 2 numbers out of 5, 3, 4 and 9, any 2 numbers, are they divisible by any common prime factor or prime number? Which 2 numbers? See, if you see 3 and 9, 3 and 9, they are divisible by 3, correct? They are in table of 3, so write 3 here. Now 5 is not divisible, so take as it is, and 4 is not divisible, so take as it is, okay? 3, divide 3 by 3, 3, 1s are 3, 9, 3s are, sorry, 3, 3s are 9, okay? 3, 3s are 9. What we have done here in this step, third step, 3 and 9 are in table of 3 or divisible by 3, so we have taken 3 here and we divided 3 by 3, 3 1s are 3 and we divided 9 by 3, 3, 3s are 9 and 5 and 4 as it is taken down, okay? Now, here, 4 is there. What one more condition is that, see, in this last line, we want all prime numbers. Now, 5 is prime number except 1. 5 is prime number, 3 is prime number, 2 is not prime number, right? 4 is not prime number. But 4 is divisible by which prime number? 2. So, write 2 here and divide 4 by 2. 2 2s are 4. Parting as it is, 1 as it is, 3 as it is. Finish, okay? Okay? So now see, these are the factors which we have obtained vertically here. These are, or we can say, these are common factors. Common prime factors. And the factors we have obtained in this way horizontally, they are non-common. They are non-common factors, okay? And you know LCM means what? LCM is equal to common factors into non-common factors. Okay, you know the LCM is common factor into non-common factors. So first take common factors. 2 into 2 into 3 into 2. They are common factors. Multiply by non-common. 5 into 1 into 2 into 3. See, when we find LCM, we have to do big multiplication because you know LCM is always greater than the given numbers. Equal to the greater number, greater than the all numbers. Okay. So see, let's multiply common factors and non-common factors. 3 2s are 6. 6 1s are 6. 6 5s are 30, correct? 30 2s are 60. 60 3s are 180. And this is 2 2s are 4. So 180 4s are 18 4s are 72, right? And 0. 4 0 0, 4 8s are 32. 2 will come down to the carry. 4 1 the 4 and 3, 7. 720. So the LCM of 10, 12, 16 and 18 is 720. The lowest number which is in table of all these numbers. Common, okay? So the 720 is the LCM of 10, 12, 16 and 18. If you are getting confused, watch the video again. because this is little lengthy method and confusing. So watch video again and fix it in your mind what are these steps, and try to solve examples by yourself afterwards. Let's see next example. Pay attention carefully. Eight, 24, 32 and 36. So if you observe all these numbers, all are divisible by which prime number? Right, 2. Let's divide 2, 8 divided by 2, 4, 24 divided by 2, 12 2s are 24, right? 12 2s are 24, that is 24 divided by 2 is 12. 32 divided by 2. Divide on the page if you are not able to divide directly here. 2 1s are 2. 2 6 are 12. So 32 divided by 2 is 16. 32 divided by 2 is 16. Okay. 36 divided by 2. If you know the table till 20, you can directly write, because you know 36. Divide by 2 means 18 to the 36. 2 1 the 2, 1 remain, 2 8 is 16. Okay, so 18 to the 36. Now new four numbers you have obtained. Let's check all four numbers are divisible by which prime number. Commonly they are divisible by which prime number? If you see that the numbers, 4 last digit, 4 2 6 and 8, they are divisible by 2. Correct? All 4 are divisible by 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2. 12 divided by 2 is 2. 6 is 12. 16 divided by 2 is 16. 8. 2 is 16. And 9. 2 is 18. Again, same numbers we have obtained. See here. 2, 6, 8, and 9. Now, except 9, these 3 numbers are divisible by. Except 9, these 3 numbers are divisible by 2, correct? So as I said to you, while finding LCM, we can take common prime factor of any 3 or any 2 or 1 also. Okay? If you are not getting common factor of all 4 numbers while finding LCM, then we can take common factor of any 3 or any 2. Okay? So now see, this 2 is common prime factor of 2, 6 and 8. So 9 is not divisible by 2, so 2, so 9 take as it is down. Okay. Divide 2 by 2, 2, 1s are 2, 2, 3s are 6, 2, 4s are 8. Later. Now here, are there all 4 numbers divisible by any common prime number? No. Any 2? Any 3? Any 3 also no. Any 2?
Yes.
Which 2? 3 and 9. See, as we have divided here, 3 and 9 by 3. 3 and 9 are in the table of 3. So 1 take as it is down, 3 divided by 3, 3 1s are 3. 4 take as it is down, 9 divided by 3, 3 3s are 9. Once again I say, in the last step we want all prime numbers. So see, 4 here, it is not prime, but it is divisible by which prime number? 2. 1 take as it is, 1 take as it is, 4 divided by 2 is 2 and 3 as it is. So all prime numbers are there and these are 1. Okay. So these are our common prime factors, these are non-common prime factors. So LCM means nothing but common factors into non-common factors. Okay, is equal to, now common factors are these, 2, 2, 2, 3 and 2, that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 2, okay, and these are now common, 1 into 1 into 2 into 3, is equal to, now see, 3 2s are 6. 6 ones are 6. 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 12 threes are 36. 36 and this 6. 2 twos are 4. 2s are 8. 36 into 8. 8 6s are 48. 8 threes are 24 and 4, 28. So the LCM is 288. 288, the number which is divisible by all these three numbers, number which is in table of all these four numbers is 288. Okay? So now you have understood the 50%, I think. 50% of the method. Let's make it more. Let's understand it more by solving next example. Okay? It's quite easy as there are zeros at the end. 30, 40, 50 and 60. If you understand the difference between between finding HCF and LCM by short division method. In HCF, highest common factor, while finding HCF by short division method, what we do? We take only a common factor in all given numbers. All given numbers, we take common factor or common prime factor in all given numbers. Whereas in LCM, we can take common factor in any, all 4 or any 3 or any 2 or any 1 also. Okay, so that is the difference. And that you have to do. Otherwise, you will get wrong LCM. So see here now 30, 40, 50 and 60. They are divisible by which prime number over first? Are they divisible by our first prime number 2? Yes, because last digit 0, that means they are divisible. So if you divide 30 by 2, 15 twos are 30, correct? So 30 divided by 2 is 15. And 40 divided by 2, 20 twos are 40. 50 divided by 2, see 50 divided by 2, 2 twos are 4. 2 5 is a 10. 25, okay? And 60 divided by 2, 2 3 is a 6, 2 3 is a 6, and 2 0 is a 0, 30. 32 is a 60. Okay? Let us see here 15, 20, 25, 30. All are divisible by which prime number? All are divisible by which prime number? 5. If you observe last between 0 or 5, right? So they are divisible by 5. 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 30. Further, 3 and 6 are divisible by 3. So 3 1s are 3, 4 take as it is down, 5 take as it is down, 3 2s are 6. 4 and 2 are divisible by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. 5 take as it is. So here see, common factors. Common prime factors. Remember, we have to divide. We have to find common prime factor, not other number. Okay? See here, if you observe, all are prime numbers as factors. So, LCM is equal to common factors into non-common factors. Okay, it's common are these 2, 5, 3, 2. 2 into 5 into 3 into 2 into non common are these 1 into 2 into 5 into 1. One 5 is a 5. 5 twos are 10, right? 10 ones are 10, 10 twos are 20, 23 are 60, 65 is a 300. 65 is a 6, 5 0 is a 0, 5 6 is a 30, 300. And 300 2s are 600. So the lowest common multiple of 30, 40, 50 and 60, the number, lowest number which is in table of 30, 40, 50 and 60 is 600. Okay, this is the lowest number which is commonly in table of all these four numbers. So in this way, we can find LCM by short division method. Now the main difference between finding HCF and HCM by short division method I have repeated you many times. Okay, so get that difference and accordingly find the LCM by short division method. Understood? Don't get confused. If you are getting confused, watch the video again. Here two examples I am giving for homework that you have to solve by yourself. Okay, watch video. If you are finding LCM of these given examples, given numbers, if you are getting any problem, watch the video again. Okay, according to that find the LCM. Okay, so find LCM of these two numbers. So hope you have understood these. If you don't understand, watch it again. Or you can ask me your doubts, okay? So thank you for today and have a nice day.